can't believe he passed away. I'll never eat meat or animal byproducts ever again. Hey guys, it's your girl Marie. Welcome back to my channel. It's been a little while since I posted a video. I'm gonna tell you what's actually been happening with me. I had a family member pass away recently, and I know you can see the title of this video. I'm gonna try not to get emotional, but I can't help but think that if this family member was leading a healthier life and eating healthier foods, that they probably would have still been here today. And this was kind of an awakening for me and for everybody that I live with. Now, I figured I would share this with you as well because I care about you guys. And hello to my 71 followers, subscribers. I just started my channel not too long ago, so I don't really have too many subscribers at the moment, but I'm happy for you guys. Happy that you guys have subscribed to me and you're looking forward to seeing new content from me. So, hi, thank you for sticking around. And if you're new and you've never met me before, like I said, my name's Marie. Thank you for coming, thank you for watching, and please go down and hit that button and subscribe, like, share, comment. I enjoy engaging with you guys in the comments. So, this family member had two strokes. The first stroke was about, I believe, 4 or 5 months ago, and he recovered, and it was important for him to get his health together. And unfortunately, he had another stroke a couple weeks ago, and he passed away September 2nd. So I'm dedicating my health going forward and my research and everything that goes with it to my uncle, because he really brought an awareness to me. I was already on the path, as you can see from my other videos, doing fastings, water fasts, meditating, etc. But I would always fall off and I wouldn't stay on course, and I would go back to eating unhealthy food, you know, burgers and so on. And he had a second stroke, passed away. And I really do believe that if he had been eating better throughout his life, he wouldn't have had so much health complications, and he wouldn't have been as overweight as he was. To not get into too many details, just out of respect for my family member and the rest of my family. Because of the recent death of my loved family member, I went online and I did research about diets and how it affects your health internal. Documentaries that really confirmed my suspicions about the relation with health and food that you eat, and whether you have chronic diseases or just your total overall health, was a documentary called Forks Over Knives. When I watched this documentary, it really drew the parallel for food and your health, and it really does correlate. Honestly, they did blood work. People would come with chronic health issues to a specific doctor. I would implore you to watch this documentary. This person had high cholesterol, high blood pressure, among other lab results that you'll see clearly in the documentary. And from that person being an unhealthy eater to following a healthy eating plan of only a plant-based diet, I believe it was vegan, yeah, but just a plant-based diet, they had dropped in about, I think, 30 days, I believe it was, they had dropped almost half the results in the lab. Certain chronic diseases can be cured. It's even known that cancer is based on your genetics, partly on your genetics and what you're predisposed to, your environment, where you live, etc. But meat is carcinogenic. It produces cancer. It can produce cancer within you. So today, or a few days ago, I probably look like I'm just all over the place, but this is the first time I'm using my light setup and I'm like blinded. I probably look like a deer in the headlights. I'm really gonna try to get it together though. But anyhow, I've decided to go vegan. I've decided that I no longer want to consume meat products, meat byproducts, no egg, no dairy, no milk, no cheese, no meat, no fish, none of that. I just want to be on a vegan, plant-based diet. I'm not gonna be totally raw, but for the last 3 days, I've just been eating fruits and vegetables, and I am totally vegan. No milk, no nothing. I never really drank milk anyways, but you know, I use almond milk, etc. When I'm making and baking meals that are vegan for my family. Some of the documentaries that I have watched that have helped me to be focused and really solidify my decision this time around to be vegan, because I was vegetarian before and I was pescatarian before, and then I fell back into eating meat again. So the two documentaries that I had watched was, as I stated before, Forks Over Knives, which really, really, really draws the correlation between your health, your physical health, your mental health, and the foods that you place into your body. And the second documentary, well, I watched this documentary first, it was Earthlings. Now, I'm not really the type of person that would cry when I watch movies, but that documentary, it's like, you know what happens when, you know, animals in your mind, it's like, okay, I know that they killed this chicken for me to eat it. I know that they killed this cow for me to eat this burger, etc., etc. But, you know, and I'm assuming you would know that somebody brutally maimed and killed this fox to make this coat, or etc. But it was totally different. I forced myself to get through the entire documentary, but I can't even lie, it was hard. It was definitely hard to get through, seeing what the animals have to go through. It just seems evil. Nothing about it was positive. Now, I know killing is not positive, but they say that we need to eat meat, you know. And even kosher slaughterhouses, it's not kosher, right? And I honestly do believe that when we consume these animals that have been slaughtered in such a way, in such a negative state, with no regard to their being or anything, that we definitely do consume that. It was horrific. That was very inhumane slaughter. I believe that animals definitely should be treated a lot better, and their lives should definitely be appreciated as our lives are appreciated. Now, you definitely wouldn't want somebody to kill a dog and eat it, kill a cat and eat it. You'd be pretty emotional about that. And these animals do have emotion. They do have consciousness. They do have sense of self and their surroundings. So the way in which they're slaughtered and killed and just treated as if really they are just a piece of meat. After watching that, I can never subscribe to that again. I do not support killing animals for them to be eaten. I believe that we can get all of our essential nutrients, proteins, vitamins from plants, and I'm just done with that. And I have to say that I am going to dedicate me wanting to be a vegan and sticking to it this time to my uncle and his life. It's terrible in this world that I'm quite sure that they know what we're eating and the animals and what it does to our body, but this world is based on money. All they really care about is who's gonna get sick, who's gonna be obese, right? And how they can continue to sell all of these things at high prices to us to eat, just to cause us to be sick, to put us in a vicious cycle of funding whatever organizations benefit from these mass killings and slaughterings of animals. I'm not any type of activist or anything like that. I'm just a person who has had to deal with a passing in her family, and I do believe that if he had been on a healthier diet, that this would have never happened. So I dedicate this to you, my loving uncle. I love you, and I know that you are in a great place. And I'm seeing the education and the lesson that you've given in your passing, that we do need to live healthier, active lives. And I'm passing it on to my family, and I'm passing it on to you. So I implore you to go out there and watch documentaries, do your research. Top two right now that I've watched in the last couple days are, as I said, Forks Over Knives and Earthlings. Earthlings, you may want to be a little bit cognizant of who you're around, like if you have little babies, etc. I personally wouldn't have them watching this, but please do watch those, do your research, and if you're interested in moving forward in a healthier lifestyle, I'm sure I'll definitely be posting some videos of some vegan meals that I've been making, talking about my progress and what I've been going through as a vegan. So once again, thank you for coming back to my channel. I hope this wasn't a depressing video at all, but I just had to say this, and I'm really firm and adamant about my decision this time to go vegan. And for anybody out there who's been going back and forth and may or may not know if it's for you or can't stick with it, just listen to my story about my uncle who passed away, and I believe that it all could have been different if he wasn't as overweight as he was, and if he was eating a lot more, I don't think these strokes would have occurred. What I was saying is your body is your kingdom, your body is your temple, and it's what's been given to you. And you should be mindful of what you put into your body. Eat healthy, whether you're doing it for health reasons, whether you're doing it for weight loss, whether you're doing it because you believe that, you know, animals have a right to live. Whatever your reasonings may be, just make sure you do your research. Make sure you're firm in your decisions and you're adamant in the direction that you're gonna go. And once you get to a place where there's no looking back, I wanna congratulate you, number one, for getting there. And number two, I wanna say it probably won't be easy, especially in the beginning. And I'm also gonna be sharing on here my ups and downs and my positivities of what I'm going through as a vegan. So thank you again for watching this video. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for all of my subscribers so far for sticking around. And I would like you to click that button below and subscribe, like, comment, and share. Are you a vegan? Have you newly become a vegan? Are you totally against being a vegan? Have you watched any of the documentaries that I've spoken about in this video? Let me know in the comments below. Have you had anybody in your family pass away from heart attack, stroke, you know, all these things, high cholesterol, congestive heart failure, all of these things which are, you know, derived from also poor eating habits and inactive lifestyles. So I am gonna be an advocate now of living healthier lifestyles, being more active, and eating better.